Hi everyone. Today in this video, I am going to talk about the side effects of lithium. Lithium is one of the smallest compounds used in medicine. It can be used as mood stabilizer to treat bipolar disorder. It is available as lithium carbonate. Lithium can control mania in bipolar disorder associated with hyper-excitability. It can also control hypomania, a similar condition with a lesser degree of hyper-excitability that lasts for shorter periods. The side effects of lithium are mild and well-tolerated. However, it should be used long-term in order to produce mood stabilization, and it has a narrow therapeutic window. Therefore, a small fluctuation in its levels in the blood can induce a significant systemic effect. Obviously, it may lead to a few important side effects. Today in this video, let's explore our discussion on these side effects of lithium and how they are managed. The side effects of lithium can be classified into three categories based on their extent and severity. The common side effects are related to gastrointestinal system. A few other side effects are related to central nervous system. A small component of side effects is associated with the skin. Most of the side effects are shortly developed, mild, and well-tolerated. However, a few side effects develop with long-term use and may be troublesome. So let's discuss the side effects of lithium one by one. The first one is diarrhea. It is the most common side effect of lithium that can be observed within the first 6 months of the treatment. It is often associated with moderate dehydration. Particularly, diarrhea can be observed when lithium levels are greater than 0.8 milliequivalents per liter in the blood. So it is better to avoid dehydration by indulging in plenty of fluids. The second one is nausea. Nausea can be observed in early days of treatment with lithium. It is more pronounced when lithium reaches its peak levels in the body. In order to minimize the nausea, it is better to take lithium after meals. Spicy foods also increase nausea, so it is better avoided. Instead of taking a single dose of lithium at a high dose, using it in divided doses may reduce nausea as it eliminates the peak levels of lithium in the body. Use of sustained release preparations can also minimize nausea. These formulations release the drugs slowly so that they can avoid the peak levels of lithium in the body. The third one is polyuria. This is the most common side effect that can be observed with the use of lithium. It is associated with frequent urination and increased urinary volume each time. The urinary volume may be increased by more than 3 liters per day. The enhanced urinary volume is due to the inability of kidneys to retain the water. It results in excessively dilute urine, which is one of the important conditions associated with use of lithium. In the renal tubules, antidiuretic hormone is responsible for absorption of water from the filtrate. On the outer membrane, antidiuretic hormone receptors are expressed, and when they are activated, they increase cyclic AMP levels within the tubular membrane. Cyclic AMP acts as an important secondary messenger. It can stimulate the expression of aquaporins, the water channels on the inner membrane of renal tubules. Water in the filtrate can be easily passed through these aquaporins into the renal membrane, where it is finally absorbed into the systemic circulation. Lithium can inhibit this process. It can inhibit the activity of ADH, thereby inhibiting cyclic AMP production. It can also damage the aquaporins with long-term use. Both of these effects can lead to a decreased absorption of water. This results in the retention of more water in the filtrate, leading to excessively dilute urine. Since water is not reabsorbed, sodium is also more retained, leading to hyponatremia. The effect of lithium on the kidney may be reversible. So on discontinuation of lithium, polyuria can be restored. However, on long-term use, it may produce some irreversible effects, which may indicate some renal structural damage. This resembles the induction of a condition like nephrogenic diabetes insipidus that is associated with polyuria. A few of the drugs like antipsychotics can also increase polyuria. Therefore, they should be carefully given. In order to minimize the induction of polyuria, lithium should be given at a once daily dose. This reduces structural damage to the renal system. Interestingly, polyuria can also be minimized by the use of diuretics like amiloride. Normally, diuretics enhance urinary volume. However, when they are combined with lithium, they can paradoxically reduce the urinary volume. In people with significant polyuria, amiloride can be used at a dose of 5 mg. Similarly, hydrochlorothiazide can be given at a dose of 50 mg. However, the use of diuretics may result in the retention of lithium in the body. That's why the dose of lithium should be properly adjusted to avoid toxicity. Potassium levels may also be reduced while combining with diuretics. If required, a potassium supplement may be given in order to manage hypokalemia. The fourth one is polydipsia. It is a condition of increased thirst that can be observed with the use of lithium. It may result in the development of a dry mouth. In a few people, it may also develop a metallic taste. Polydipsia may be associated with polyuria. Due to the loss of more water from the body, the thirst centers may be stimulated, leading to polydipsia. However, in a few people, this polydipsia can also be observed without any development of polyuria. Dry mouth can be controlled by chewing sugarless gums that induce salivation. Glycerin-based oral moisturizers can also be used to manage the dry mouth. However, in people with severe dry mouth, cholinergic mouthwashes can also be used. The fifth one is tremors. The use of lithium can produce some tremors in hands. They are distinct from Parkinson's disease, so they are not related with dopamine pathway. Lithium-induced tremors can be increased by a few conditions. A high intake of caffeine or pre-existing anxiety may increase the induction of tremors. For the people with recent alcohol withdrawal, they may be more pronounced. Lithium-induced tremors are particularly pronounced in the elderly. It is better to avoid a high intake of caffeine to minimize tremors. For people with serious hand tremors, beta blockers like propranolol or vitamin B6 supplements may be helpful. The sixth one is weight gain. An increase in the weight gain is observed within 1 to 2 years of treatment with lithium. However, it is not clear that this weight gain is associated with lithium. For people with hypothyroidism, this side effect can be more pronounced. Since lithium increases thirst, an intake of high-calorie drinks can also add to the weight gain from long-term use. In people with edema, again, this effect is more pronounced. All these are the predisposing factors that may increase weight gain. An increase in the weight can be controlled by avoiding high-calorie drinks, diet control, and proper exercise. It is also better to avoid few of antidepressants, which again increase body weight. The seventh one is cognitive impairment. The use of lithium may reduce thinking capabilities as well as creativity in people. It may also cause some confusion. These cognitive effects are dose-related and clearly observed with high dose of lithium. Therefore, it is better to use a low dose in case of cognitive impairment. The eighth one is the weakness. The use of lithium can produce some tiredness and dizziness in the people. It can also produce blurred vision and ataxia, a muscle incoordination that may result in loss of balance. These are commonly observed with use of lithium, particularly in the initial days. The ninth one is the effect on thyroid. Lithium can inhibit thyroid hormone synthesis, leading to reduced thyroid levels in the body. That's why long-term use of lithium may lead to hypothyroidism. Interestingly, it can also produce a quite opposite effect. Lithium can modify the thyroid levels, so either it can increase or decrease their levels. Even hypothyroidism is commonly observed in many people with use of lithium, but in a few people, hyperthyroidism can also be observed. The 10th one is the effect on skin. Lithium can produce some skin rashes. In people with pre-existing skin disorders, skin exfoliations may be increased. The effect of lithium on the skin is dose-dependent. These skin reactions are observed with a high dose of lithium. The last one is the effect on calcium. Long-term use of lithium can produce hyperparathyroidism. With elevated parathyroid hormones, calcium levels are also increased. So with long-term use of lithium for several years, calcium levels should be closely monitored. So these are the 11 important side effects of lithium. Most of the side effects are mild and well tolerated, but a few side effects are particularly related to long-term use of lithium. Effect on kidney, thyroid hormone, and parathyroid hormone are observed over long term. However, they can be minimized by taking proper precautions. So that's all about the important side effects of lithium. That's for today. Thanks for watching this video.